Hi everyone, welcome to Mesh Math. Today we are going to study from class 10th chapter 2 polynomials, the introduction part of it. So, first of all, we'll try to understand what is polynomial. You have already studied in 9th class, but still, once again, let's recall. So, what is polynomial? A combination of constants. Constants meaning the numbers. Okay? Combination of constants, variables. Variables means all this A to Z, all the English alphabetics. So a combination of constants and variables and operators. Operators meaning all this plus, minus, division, multiplication, all these are called operations. So a combination of constants, variables and operators is called algebraic expressions, because in 9th standard you have studied algebraic expressions. So the combination of constants, variables and operators, they are called algebraic expressions. So let's say an example, this is an algebraic expression. These are algebraic expressions because we have the variable here and we have the operator here. And then we have a constant here. I told you constant means numbers, variable means the English alphabets, operator means the signs. Okay, so that are called algebraic expressions. So if you see here, you see a variable is there and a operator is there and a constant is there. So these all are algebraic expression. Now in this, which one is polynomial? Because a polynomial means an algebraic expression of which exponents of variable is a whole number is called a polynomial. So what is polynomial? When you see an algebraic expression where the exponent of the variable is a whole number, that is called the polynomial. So now let's see here which one is a polynomial, because these all are algebraic expressions. So we have to see the exponent. We have to see the exponent of the variable, whether that is having a whole number or not. So if you see in this, so the this is a variable. So here the exponent is 1. Exponent meaning is power. So the power is 1. So that means 1 is a whole number. Therefore this is a polynomial. So this is a polynomial. Let's check. Now this is root x. What is the meaning of root x? Root x can be written like this. See, root x can be written like this, x and 1 upon 2. This is what we write like this. So now 1 upon 2, is it a whole number? No, this is not the whole number. Therefore, this is not a polynomial. So this algebraic expression is not a polynomial. Now here you see, this is 1 upon x. Now 1 upon x can be written like this. 1 you write as it is. When x comes up, it will become minus 1, because here the power is 1. So when it comes up, it becomes minus 1. Now minus 1 is not the whole number. So therefore, this is not a polynomial. I hope now you understood what is polynomial. Polynomial means algebraic expression which has the exponent of the variable whole number, that is called polynomial. So we saw, so this is polynomial because the variable exponent is whole number, whereas here the variable exponent is not the whole number here. Therefore this is not the polynomial. So now after having understood what is polynomial, let's take one expressions and learn all the parts of the polynomial. So now we have taken one expression, that is 5x cubed minus 4x square plus x plus 2. So now if you see variables are here, variables power is whole number. So that means this is a polynomial. So in this polynomial, let's see the each part how we call it. So terms, there is something called terms. Terms meaning all this 5x cubed, 4x square, x, 2, all these are called terms. We call it terms. How many terms are here? 1, 2, 3, 4 terms are there. So these are called terms. Then something called coefficient. Coefficient means any number with variables. So variables means, you know already I have told you that alphabets A to Z, all the alphabets are called variables. Okay. So now coefficient means any number with variables. So now any number with variable. This is a variable. So the number with variable. So 5 is a coefficient. So 4 is a coefficient. because this is with variable. Now here there is 1 is there, so that we can call it as a coefficient. But this is not coefficient because here no any variables, so this is not a coefficient. But 5 is coefficient, 4 is coefficient, and 1 is coefficient. So that is the meaning of coefficient. Now something called variables. I already told you variable meaning. Already I explained to you from A to Z the alphabets we call it variables. Then exponent. Exponent also above here the example I explained to you. Exponent means only whole number should be there on the power of the variable. So there should not be no fractions, no root, no decimals. So no fraction, roots, decimals on the power of the variable. So the power of the variable should be only whole number. So exponent we call it. Exponent means the power. The powers are called exponents. So this is now here in this case which is exponent. 3 is the exponent, 2 is the exponent, here 1 is the exponent. So the power of the variables. So the power of the variable, these are called exponent. So this is variable, this is coefficient, this is exponent. So this is variable, sorry, this is coefficient, variable, exponent. Here 1 is there, so that becomes the coefficient, this is variable, and here also 1 is there, that becomes exponent. So now next, this exponent should be what? Should be only whole number, that you have to remember. Should be only whole numbers. Now constant. Constant meaning, I said any number without variable. So here no variable, so 2 becomes the constant. So this part is clear. Now let's move on to degree of a polynomial. This also you have studied in class 9, but still I'll explain to you. Now degree of a polynomial. What is degree of a polynomial? The highest power of x in P of x. P of x means the polynomial. So highest power of x in polynomial is called the degree of the polynomial. What is that? Highest power. Highest power of the x or a variable you can say. The highest power of variable. That is called degree of the polynomial. So it is variable. Not necessary. It has to be x. So the highest power of variable is called the degree of the polynomial. So if you see here example, now p of x or the polynomial here, which is the highest power of variable we have to see, and not the numbers, the highest power of the variable. So here the variable is x. What is the highest power? Highest power is 1 is there. So if 1 is there, then what type of polynomial? It is a linear polynomial. So now here you see the highest power. The highest power is 2. This variable is here x. The highest power is 2. Therefore, when highest power is 2, we call the degree of this polynomial is 2. So highest power is called degree. So here the highest degree is 1. Here highest degree is 2. So when the highest degree is 2, we call it quadratic polynomial. Now here in this case, you see the highest degree is 3. Highest degree or highest power, whatever you want to say. So that we call it degree, since we say degree of a polynomial. So the highest power is the degree. So here the degree is 3. So if it is 3, then we call it as a cubic polynomial. So this all you have studied in class 9th, but still let us remember once again. Now we go to the important part of the topic, that is zeros of the polynomial. This also in class 9th you have studied, but still let us remember. Zeros of the polynomial. Value of the variable which will make the value of the polynomial, we say zero of that polynomial. Means value of the variable. So any expression is here. So variable is there. So you give any value to that variable and that will bring that polynomial to zero. So that is called zero of the polynomial. So with expression you will understand here. Just see here, we have here one example polynomial x minus 3. So in the place of x, let's put in the place of x 0, then solve it here. So in the place of x we are putting 0. So 0 means 0 minus 3 will give us minus 3. And in this case, well, let us put in the place of x 1. So if we are putting 1, then 1 minus 3. What answer we will get? We will get minus 2. So let's put now in the place of x 2. So value of 2, let us put in the place of x 2. So then 2, then minus, then 3. So we will get minus 1 answer. So now let us put in the place of x 3. So if we put 3, then minus, then 3. So value will become plus 3 minus 3, it will become 0. So now we call 3 is the 0 of the polynomial p of x equal to x minus 3. So 3 is 3. 3, because when we gave the x value 3, then we got the answer for this polynomial. So therefore 3 will become the 0 of this polynomial. I hope this is clear to you. 0 of the polynomial doesn't mean 0, means in the place of x, which value you are giving, that value will make that polynomial to 0. So that value we call it 0 of that polynomial. So here in this case we saw, when we put 0, we did not get 0. When we put 1, we didn't get 0. When we put 2, we didn't get 0. But when we put 3, the value of 3 gave us 0. So that means 3 becomes the 0 of this polynomial. That's it. Thank you and God bless you.